Hello everyone, welcome back to Isaac. We just did a Judas streak after a challenge. So I think I'm going to do another challenge. Our streak is back on one. So I'm going to try and not do that any disservice by crashing it. So let's do a challenge, which is not going to fuck up our streak. Yeah. I think this just has Pokemons in it, right? Yeah. Wow, that's interesting. Okay, I've never seen that come out of one of those before, but I guess I'm okay with it. Because it means that I can basically do both sides of the room at the same time, but I'm watching it. So, you know, that is distracting. So try not to let it distract you. That's actually really useful, companion. Do we get item rooms? I suspect not. Also, I'm trying not to get it hit, which means I'm dodging for two. Which is what happens when you get... when you're pregnant. This is terrible. When your Pokemon dies, you get another one for free, which is nice. And if you can keep it alive, then you get another one after three anyway. So Squeezy actually super helps right now, because we get these two Spirit Hearts, which makes up for the one we lost because I was trying to dodge for two. That was actually really good fun. And if... it's an interesting idea for a game, actually. Or a mod for Isaac, whereby, I guess it's similar to Isaac, to Jacob and Esau, except instead of having just two players that move around at the same time, basically, you would have rooms designed for a situation like that, where one of you is moving opposite to the other one, and you have to keep him alive. We're getting goodies that I've never seen out of... And I've never seen Charm before, basically. I don't know if you can get these out of the Pokey Go item. I didn't realise that he was there, or I would have, you know, put some more effort into not walking into the shot. It's also a little bit confusing to remember which one is yours and which one is not. I'm going to shoot all these poops because it could be very lucrative for us. If we can get a... an arcade on the next floor, we can get some good stuff out of it. Especially if we have a way of healing. Obviously, we want to keep our Pokemon's item. And I'm assuming there's no item rooms, because it seems like the sort of thematic challenge that prevents you from replacing the item. Or at least discourages you from replacing the item. Although now I would like to have... You're quite annoying. I'd like to have 7 cents now, but... No, I wouldn't. If there's no item rooms... There's no point buying that item. Good thinking. Right, I'm glad I shot that fire. Now we have 5 cents. We can get a room cursed. Did you just take damage from that? Nope, leave. I think this friend of ours is actually quite likely to have some positive effect for us. Don't leave the room until the Pokeball's open. Okay. So I think if any of your Pokemans dies, you get... oh, brilliant. Well, there's no actual blood bank in here, which is kind of bullshit, but okay. If either Pokemon dies, or if any of your Pokemons die, then you get your charge back. Like, this particular one it's constantly popping up. This is a very good room, by the way. I'm surprised I did so well. I was going to say, it seems difficult to die, but it walks full tilt into an enemy that can do it damage, so whatever. How has these flies survived this amount of time? Yeah, kill it. Good. I can only imagine the amount of damage that thing just did to Pride. This thing is very vulnerable, but it avoids enemies, so... We could change our space bar, but I'm not going to. It avoids enemies, so it's a lot less likely to take damage except by accident. That's really good. A key dropping champion that dropped a golden key is rare but appreciated. So, I mean, with the shots being this good, it's hard to suggest that the Pokemon's challenge is actually a challenge. But I think I'm going to stick to the theme of it. We have plenty of runs in which to get something as fairly mundane as the brain fart. Yo, what that thing called, though? deck of cards. That's what I mean. It's also kind of difficult to know which shots to actually fucking dodge. And of course, we have a lover's card, which means it would be great to have found a an arcade that we could make use of, but we didn't. So there's that. Monstro is not very useful, charmed like that. Neither is this particular enemy Pokemon all that useful. We're trying not to get hit again because having been hit by Champion Monstro already, we're super likely to lose our deal with the devil, which is presently guaranteed and probably very useful considering we have no recourse in terms of item rooms, basically. Another tiers upgrade is brilliant. And these are both shit. I mean, Mom's Knife is pretty good, but I'm not sure. Well, I guess if we're at one heart, but we have Mom's Knife, it's not that bad, right? So we'll probably take that. Should do us a great amount of good. I guess. Well, for a start, we check out other rooms. This is the basement, so this is our best opportunity to explore and get random spirit hearts or check out this boss trap room and things like that. It's super difficult not to dodge your own friend's shots. Because it's very instinctive. Brilliant. We got a bomb, by the way, so I'm going to put this here. Oh, my goodness. I am extremely pleased by that. Yeah, fire gave a spirit heart. I can't really complain. Yeah, we do have Mom's Knife now. So it'd be a bit rich not to, basically. I'm trying to juggle having to charge Mom's Knife without an indicator, which is how Mom's Knife works, and know when to reset my Pokemon. Red Heart is not too useful. But we will continue. That's Anarchist Cookbook, which we don't need. We've got a great rate of fire, and I think that basically manifests as your charge time for Mom's Knife. So we should be able to get through this pretty quickly, although we do have to beat Isaac. With nothing but Pokemons. And Mom's Knife. So I'm glad that we didn't get that extra hit that we could have taken against Champion Monstro in a small room very easily. Big Monstro, little room is rife for taking unwanted and unnecessary damage. Not doing too well on any consumables except for money right now either. So we can't get anything of great value to ourselves. Plus, I don't like these particular enemies because there's a strong chance that they just shoot you when you have to line up with them because you're using Mom's Knife. It is possible to diagonally fire Mom's Knife, but having to let go of both buttons simultaneously in order to do so is, it's not easy. It's a non-trivial task. Of course, you could do contact damage with Mom's Knife. You can melee them, but again, non-trivial task. Seem to be getting my sea legs back underneath me. You know, the horse that I fell off is not really bucking right now. That implies we have a library. That's an interesting prospect. What an interesting... I've never considered that room before. I've never seen that room before. With the new content pack that we got, I just realized how good this enemy is. I wish I could heal them. There may be more rooms as well as... more items. I'm not actually sure. I haven't read the cliff notes of the contents of the content pack, which is a strange thing to say, but say I did. Latchkey is also fine, and even more spirit hearts. So I think now what we might want to do is actually go and get that eternal heart, because I'd rather have a red heart than a blue heart at this stage. And we'll go into both of these in case they can give us any particular benefit. 15 cents for an unknown item. We could find the secret room here. We didn't, but we got our money back, and then we'll buy the spirit heart. Don't really think I need to buy the the key, but I could be wrong. Well, I've got a used diaper. Probably something to do with flies. I honestly don't know. from that enemy, I won a fly and a piece of damage, which is going to haunt me forever. Did you see how it didn't explode when it hit that? I'm confused. Why aren't you exploding? Do you do any damage at all, or just not shit damage? Two of Space seems better than the Lover's card right now. Not too worried about the damage that we took just now. And the reason for that is mostly... I mean, what am I doing? Mostly because we're going to get another HP on the next floor, so... But I guess whatever. Oh, a Viz. I like that. And they don't hurt each other, which is brilliant. So we have a fair little cohort behind us now. Although, that Brimstone is going to scare the crap out of me every single time it happens. I have 2.5 HP for the next floor and 1 key, which is fine with me. Possibly could have gotten away with using the joke at the Lover's card by now, but whatever. Trevor, whatever. We might get some value out of the... Let's try the Fortune Teller, see if we get some Spirit Hearts or a trinket that I understand. Devil card is fine. The Joker card is even more fine. So... I guess what we should do is take the Devil card until we learn that we have no deal with the Devil. It's a long way back, though. I don't really care to backtrack that much. It seems a little bit tedious. I mean, the right thing to do would be to take the Devil card into the boss fight. Try and earn a deal with the Devil naturally by fighting the boss with bonus damage. And if that fails, how? If that fails... Oh, wow. Okay. You go back and get the Joker card and use it. If you are gonna use a Joker card... Oh, you're mine, you're not. I understand. If you're gonna use a Joker card, you want to ensure that you take Red Heart damage at that point. Oh yeah, you're mine. They're on my side. That's probably a shop, so there's no point going in it. Nope. Mm-hmm. Possibly worth the bomb? I really couldn't tell you. Seems like a little bit like theory crafting to figure out whether that was even the correct thing to do. But I did it, so it's a bit late to work out whether it's the correct thing to do. So if we do get a deal with the Devil, we should go into the curse room and get and take Red Heart damage. No. It's the other way around. If you have a Joker card and use it, you should intentionally take Red Heart damage to avoid getting the deal with the Devil that you've already seen. This is so confusing with all these shots on the screen that I am pausing as being hostile, but don't necessarily appear to be. Rag Mega. He's probably going to die pretty quickly, so that's nice, but I'm going to get stuck. Fuck. We did get HP back, which at least causes us not to have an horrible time. I think we do want Succubus, which we paid for already. And I should go to the curse room. Is there HP on the ground? There is. So taking the damage on the curse room now is fine. Interesting. I think I hurt everything on the screen, even though it was on my side. We'll check this out. Not worth the time. Then we'll come back and just pick up the HP and go. Oh well, plenty of keys, that's nice though. That's half a heart. Oh, you bastard. I'm too lazy to look for another half, so 3 hits is good enough. It was a shame that Rag Mega was a very unpredictable fight, apart from the confusion caused by the Pokemons themselves. We did sufficient damage on the first hit that it threw its... bullet at me before I could really pause what was happening. That room was bullshit. Alright, let's try this again, after a quarter of an hour of recording. And hopefully we get just as good advantages, but that was a really good run to throw away, but I have no idea how you would deal with that room. It's not a room I've seen before, and I've talked about this before, but on normal mode, we actually have a different array of room options than you get in hard mode. So it's quite likely that there will be rooms that I've not seen before and haven't yet worked out correctly how to approach. You know, and I never really know how to approach people, which is why I'm so lonely all the time. And I cry myself to sleep at night. Listening to Radiohead and the Eels. We just picked up the raw liver, which is 2 HP, which is a lot of HP for me, because I had 3 and now I have 5, so we just increased ourselves in HP terms by 66% recurring, of course. We know there are no item rooms, so there's no point looking for one. Ragman, you are charmed. Kindly act charmed. Wow, okay. Please. Die. Okay, good. We're actually doing a significant amount of damage to Ragman right now. Pleases me. I was going to say, where the hell did that bony come from? Don't worry. It's mine. Since we have a golden key, we should definitely check out... Wait, are there item rooms? All of a sudden, I'm not sure. Since we have a golden key, we should check out this. We should also explore to see if we get any golden chests, which could give us an advantage in the future. And we might want to blow up that place for that key, because we don't have another one. There are cursed rooms, though, so that was worth checking out. Good. Well done. Charmed enemies, when there's no other enemy on the screen, I reckon should at least have some effect. Like, maybe they'll hurt themselves rather than you. Something like that. A mushroom. Interesting. Dagars. We'll save this for the next floor. First of all, there's a chance that there will be a, a curse, which we want to purge. Obviously, there isn't one now. And secondly, it will give us a spirit heart. And I want to make sure that I'm not going to do a foolish thing like walk into a fire between here and our spirit heart. Bomb for a key. Probably not worth it, considering we're only going to be using one key per floor, because we're not going to go to item rooms. Well, besides ancillary ones like chests. Which means maybe we look for a secret room. I think we look for a secret room on the next floor instead of a super secret room on this floor. Hopefully we don't spend too long on this, because obviously dying after a quarter of an hour is a pain in the ass. Curse of the anything? No. But we'll use it anyway. Give ourselves a little bit of protection. Please. Can we do this from over here? I accidentally exploded my bony. Wow. I'm happy to trade that bony for whatever you call these. Because first of all, this is a monster spawner. Second of all, it has a lot more HP than most of the enemies on this floor. Again, unfortunately, can't heal it. So we've got a shop. That's the one thing we're most likely to be... well, you exploded yourself. And I exploded your friends. Swings and roundabouts, I guess. Secret room? Nope. I think it was worth the effort. Although, it seems likely that the secret room is on this side, so we could have got the same amount of money and found the secret room. And possibly not used our only bomb as a result, because... could have found one in the secret room, something like that. I don't know. I'm not sure about this mushroom friend. Seems okay, but not quite as worthwhile as you might anticipate. Trying to keep track of all these friends of ours. Flippy kids on the corner begins. I know it's an Elbow song, but I don't think it's on Build a Rocket Boys. So you should have a constant supply of familiars, basically, and you should be getting more and more as time goes on, because every time one dies, you get one back. Right? And yet, why have I now only got one? Maybe it only happens once per room. That could be a thing. This enemy seems like a decent one as well, because again, it spawns in inoffensive locations and beats the shit out of things. Yeah, sure. What do we win? Far too. I don't want that one. I think that's the one that causes explosions when you don't want them? Something like that. It's scary. I seem to remember it's scary and you don't want it. Okay. Maybe an angel run. Now we go and spend our spirit heart, I guess, on them. Why are you there shooting that way? On the curse room. Considering that we can't even find the secret room next to it, even if it is there. Which it could be. Please, if you're going to be a familiar of mine, can you, like, be better? I think we're going to the shop. Sackhead would be great, but it's not on offer. Maybe we buy the bomb and try and get to the secret room somehow? Going to spend this HP on here, because we've already got our deal with the devil on this floor. Small chance of getting one on the next floor, and honestly, taking the red heart damage to not get one on the next floor is not that big of a deal. How did you miss? Cool. Right. Yeah, I'm going to buy a bomb. Try for the secret room. Or just buy our spirit heart back. These difficult are decisions. And I'm never quite sure what to do. Yeah, that seems like a reasonable play. It seems like the conservative but sensible way of doing it. Which is what I'm going to have to go for, because I already died on the first edition of this challenge. And remember, we could have taken a couple of different spacebar items instead of the Pokemon's item. I think we do this because we don't have any item. Yeah. Now I'm wishing that I bought the bomb and look for the secret room, because the spirit heart is now essentially meaningless. We have 5 HP. 50% chance of the deal with the angel anyway. 50% chance of the deal with the devil too, but deal with the angel is the surprising instance, so we should mention that. And then, please. Thank you. If we get deals with the angel, of course, we don't need to worry about the HP in the first place. So we've still got this Joker fighting around doing this. Now we have an explodey fly, which could explode us, so do be careful. Flippy kids on the corner, be... Go. Kill. Okie dokie. Somehow we have survived. Yep, you're still alive. Okay. Well, I'll tell you what's likely to happen is that if a Pokemon dies just like that, great, by killing itself and thus ending the room that would have given us a charge anyway, we're down by one Pokemon. Make sense? You're spawning enemies that I'm not sure if are mine or not. Also, an exploding Pokemon can take out other Pokemons, and of course they could just die at the same time in many other ways. So there are ways of losing Pokemon. But by and large, the economy is in our favor. Simply because every time we lose one, we get one back. Semi-sustainably. There's a lot of them about. Oh, I assume there's one here. Maybe there was and our Pokemon destroyed it. See, now I have a lot of money but no keys. It was mildly dangerous, but we achieved it. Nevertheless, what is here? I understand. Oh, now everything is on the screen and I can't see what's going on and things are going to explode in my face and we're going to kill a lot of Pokemons by doing that. That got everything? I think we've reset our Pokemons with that one. Well, this one's going to explode, please. Yep. And then we do this and get another one. This is a shitty little fly, which will die pretty quickly. We want to be careful about that. We want to watch it happen and then make a new one. We want to make sure, basically, not to accidentally waste a charge. I would like to get into the shop and into the rest of that room, but it doesn't seem too likely. (Clears Now, Broken Modem is a shop item. It could actually help us out a lot on this run, because enemies like this get shit on by lag. Why are there so many explodey things in my life? Seen that? That's what we like to see. Excuse me. My Pokemon died. Where is my charge? Maybe not every single death of a Pokemon actually gives you a charge back. Like maybe it's only the ones that you spawned on that room. Ow. Yeah, angels. Which is fine. More protective hearts, but at this stage, it really doesn't matter what type of hearts you end up with. Might as well take the rosary, and no more keys, no more shits to give, so let's just move on. I'd like to move this run on a little bit faster, because the one that we lost, presumably due to my own complete inability to follow what the hell was going on, was 14 minutes long, so I want to not have the world's longest video just by having two runs in it, but also dying at 14 minutes is extremely irritating. From a gameplay standpoint, I guess. Please. Thank you. No, that's no good. We should get that one back at some point. Fine. The enemies that we are receiving as Pokemons are questionable. That was a good dodge. Well done, me. Why do I deserve that? I didn't see any of my Pokemons die. The doors are open. That means everything's mine. Oh, it's so confusing. Please. The angel feeds could be good as well because they teleport around. Is that mine or yours? Come on. It has hearts. No, that has hearts. No. Is that mine? Just shoot it. If it takes damage, it's... It doesn't have hearts over it, see? Tyrone. I have a bugbear. I rolled a bugbear. I didn't think they were playable creatures. You can play anything if you're an experienced RPer. Yeah? So much on the screen. Some of which is occasionally mined by accident. Some of which is permanently mine, but dies, and I have to pay attention. Wow. Please. Help me. Woo! Okay, good. Still looking out for many things of advantage. For example, tinted rocks. Consumables of any description, that would be a nice start. Yeah, you kill them. Take it out on each other, as far as I'm concerned. I had pink milk, but I think I've drunk it. Sad. These enemies that... Ow, good shot. That spawn near the doorway with me are fairly useless, I'll be honest. Because in order for them to really do any damage, they have to be near an enemy, and once they're stationary, then that enemy is just as likely to hit them as anything else. We can't get to the boss trap room. Wow. And even if we did find the shop, we haven't really got any money. This is great. Honestly. I could be on the other side of the map. Where did you go? Were you being injured by the... poop? That implies that enemies' poop hitboxes are actually slightly larger than my own. Which explains a couple of hunches that you may receive as an Isaac player as you go along, which is that enemies' poop hitboxes seem to be bigger than your own. You can almost coerce an enemy to take damage by running it into a poop. That's pretty nice. We'll see about the super bandage. Almost tempted just to take Book of Belial to end this madness, but... Nah, we're going to see through the Pokemon challenge in and of itself. We've already done a Judas run recently. We've already done a challenge run recently. We've already given up, excuse me, the deck of cards recently because We see it all the time. We actually got a key. That's interesting. We're playing this run sort of on theme. We're RPing this run, okay? That was an amazing shot. What the heck? I'm going to use the fact that you're charmed to do all my damage. This Bony, seriously, is a fucking sniper crack shot Bony. What the hell? Interesting room that basically caused me no challenge. This Bony is my Bony. There are many just like it, but this one is mine. Leaper's gonna leap. Charmer's gonna charm. Please, get rid of this bloody portal. It shot me. Really do not like these enemies that shoot in six directions. Very difficult to actually avoid them, even though there's big gaps between their shots. Because you have to see where the gaps are in time. You have poor range. Ooh. I mean, I think there's more of a chance that you don't get hit than you do get hit if you just stand still. And I can't back that up with any evidence or even a theory as to why it might be. You know, this is a game of hunch.
Sanctuary!
We hunch back. Thank you for playing. Probably worth it. Absolutely, certainly, definitely worth it. Do we have any other guppy items? I don't think so. I think that's a good idea, and then we do that. Okay. Now we want to take red heart damage to avoid getting that deal with the devil, which we are guaranteed anyway. I don't think there's a way of intentionally taking red heart damage without getting rid of all my spirit hearts. So we're just going to have to live with it. Live with the fact that we have... Oh, hello. A guaranteed deal with the devil that we don't need. That's fine, because it didn't cost us anything in the first place. We didn't spend a Joker card on it. We only spent one spirit heart on it. And I'm currently talking about taking damage in order to avoid getting it again. Well, since we've already spent HP on it, there's no point spending more HP on not getting it. We might as well just, you know, let it be as it wants to be. It's really nice to get Sin Robes. It's a very... It's a decent luck upgrade. Damage upgrade. It's not a luck upgrade. Whew! What are you talking about, bro? Deep pockets. I'm not sure any of this is good enough. Yeah, I think we've got to go a little bit better with this. Let's see if we can get something else. Five bombs doesn't help. Not at the price. Let's see what this is. Two of hearts. Ugh. Now I can't afford anything, which is the annoying thing. There's no point going deeper because we can't buy anything. Unless we spent some HP on that, but I'm not going to. A lot of HP on that as well. Could have bought a bomb and maybe got a free reroll or some HP out. What is happening? You really have to react fast to that room, don't you? It's truth. Please don't die on the fire. Pretty bad place for me to have put that. What a strange layout of a floor. Where the heck is my boss? At this stage, I don't really want to go back to the shop to buy more stuff. So again, if one of these Pokemons dies and thus ends the room, not even a bomb. If we had a bomb, then it might be tempting. Okay. With a dime, and also Dart Bomb can take that. Yeah, there we go. With a dime, it's probably worth going back to the shop. Because it's a dime. Now I've got Dart Bomb and Rotten Baby added to my perpetual list of enemies that can't hurt me. I'm going slightly mad trying to figure out what is and is not true anymore. Now they've got enough money and a lot of bombs, actually. We can spend the bombs here. Is battery worth anything? I don't think so. Take spider mud. I like having the occasional effect. bought the bomb just because we'd used a couple of bombs, and they could be offensively useful in the future. Now, this is turning out to be quite a long run. It's already a long video, because of the 15-minute failure that we had at the front of it. We're already at nearly 20... Well, we're at 19 minutes. It's not fair to call it nearly 20 minutes when it's literally only just 19 minutes. We also get to see the HP of our Pokemons. So we've got a good idea of when they're going to die, and therefore when we can expect to want to produce a new one. This seems like a secret room to me. Not a secret room. It doesn't really seem like a secret room, so I probably shouldn't put a bomb there. Trying to kill these things is a lot more trouble than it's currently worth. Oh, you're not one of mine. Okay. Look at that incubus thing. Turns out you can just cajole those things onto the spikes and it works fine. I don't know what I was worried about. All these Pokemons fighting for me is actually turning out really well. The shooty ones are the best ones because they can just sort of target select on their own. Help me out quite fast. That was close. Another one bit the dust. But I still have to remember which ones are mine. So, yeah, guaranteed deal with the devil, but, you know. I got a blood clot. Did I mean to? Yes. I mean, we could get rid of our HP, but I guess why? Because we're going a long way. There's more deals with the devil, and having 2 HP at this stage is not that big of a deal. It costs us 1 spirit heart to lose... To gain the HP, you have to lose a spirit heart from the other end, but I'm really not that bothered. Fine. Lots of keys. Basically means I should not have bought any keys, which is fine, because I didn't buy any keys. I probably don't need that many keys. Yeah, let's take petrified poop, because we can get some good stuff out of these poops that still exist right now. It'd be great if petrified poop also caused a consumable to drop from poop enemies. That'd be really good. Like a way of buffing it. And it doesn't need a buff. But it seems thematically relevant. Do you not agree? No? I'm glad that this incubus thing is on my side, because when it's not on my side, it's bullshit. I hate them. So much stuff is going on right now. We basically can't die thanks to Dark Bomb. And we're getting a lot of value out of the Pokeball right now. Pardon me, what? That was a lot of our Pokemons all defeated at once there, I think. Which is sad times, but you can't win them all. I'm just trying to work out which ones are mine so I know what to ignore for the next runes. Careful. I think the bouncy around thing is not mine. That was a great time to charm an enemy, by the way. Just before it walked into me. Ah, the leapers are the ones that I'm really struggling to keep track of right now. Question marks. I'm drowsy. That's fine, actually. I'm okay with that. I mean, again, we're not in a difficult position. We don't need anything in there. We don't need the HP because Dark Bomb exists at all. We don't need the ladder because we don't need the ladder. Thank that's to... There is a spirit heart that I should go and get. The mom fight is liable to be extremely confusing for everybody involved because I'm going to have to know which ones are mine in order to not shoot them. Oh, we should check for a curse room, actually. I'm going to spend the time to check for a curse room because we need more advantages on this particular run. Because... That was bad. I got stuck on a rock. On chasm, actually. We need more advantage on this run because there's no item rooms. We didn't get one. But, okay. Hit that. We did get some bombs and a penny. Oh, actually, there's more to explore. So don't count your chickens before they're all in one basket. We can't get into this room. That's a shame. We had enough money to earn... I'm attacking things that are not mine. That are mine, that are not worth of attacking. We had enough money to get an arcade, so there's a chance we can get into the boss trap room. But There's too much stuff on the screen. Most of it's mine. It's basically my own fault. By not letting them die enough. Just keep throwing. More! More! It's the boom. Those are mine. Okay. No arcade. So, I guess we're not going to the boss trap room. Let's not get confused by a swastika room if we can avoid it. And we'll just fight Mom. Heck it. Done really well, actually. We've got a massive cohort of enemies, enemies, but Pokemon behind us. Which, as I mentioned, is liable to cause a lot of confusion on the Mom fight, but it's also liable to get it done quickly. So, sort of swings and roundabouts here. There's no point buying HP from the shop, and we can't really afford anything else except for the, we could probably consider... What? Red Mom, what are you doing? That was Blue Mom. Why are you pretending to be Red Mom, Blue Mom? Because I want to make sure that I get my Pokemons out whenever I can. This is terrible. I can't see the... Shadow, it is Red Mom. Right, now that I know it's Red Mom, I'm way less confused. That was just terrible. Although I'm way less confused, it doesn't mean I'm any actual better at the game. So, you know, deal with it. We could explode that Tinted Drop with Mom. Again, stop being bad at the game. I did get trapped. Still not an excuse. We want to deal with the devil, though. That's quite unlikely. I think I want to be able to fly. There's no point taking the other item at all. So we'll just do that. Now we don't need to worry about many things, including getting stuck on holes in the ground, which has happened, or walking on spikes, which has happened. I'm going to complain about my coccyx again, because, again, I'm still sitting on this chair that is not actually designed to be sat on, apparently. I thought it was possibly because of the way I was sitting, which is with my feet up on this box thing that I've got under the desk. So I was leaning back. And therefore, I was putting pressure on the wrong part of my spine. Nah, it just hurts like shit. I hate it. Chariot, huh? I forgot until just now. Spirit of the Night actually also gives you... I don't need this. Spectral Tears. So, we should be fairly okay from now on. With Spirit of the Night, Blood Cut is fairly good. And... the Sin Robes giving us offensive. What? Offensive stuff. Oh. I do like it in this particular chat. And then Dark Bum basically winning the game for us from a defensive standpoint. It's hard to lose. Although possible. So. Still try not to. I guess the trick to this... Oh, that one's mine. Just ignore the Pokemons, I think, is going to be my trick from now on, because the majority of the problems that I'm going to be having is trying not to let them die and trying to dodge myself into places that is an issue for. So we might as well just let it be. If they die, they die. I'll give you some money. What gives us 100% deal with the devil chance? Did we pick up the goat head? I don't think we picked up the goat head. We did pick up the goat head. Okay. Strength. That's probably good for the guaranteed deal with the devil chance we're going to get. We might want to come back and get the Emperor card. Oh, kind of like to have paid out. A different time. Probably want the strength card. If there's anything worth having in the deal with the devil, we want to... pay less for it. So I'm also checking for Tinted Rocks because we're not that out of the woods yet. Mostly because of all the damage I've been taking trying to keep my Pokemons alive, you know? And our actual damage is still not good enough to kill a single spider in a single hit. So that's a problem. Basically, if we reroll into something that we want with the Purrthrow rune, we still want the strength card in order to buy it. We can't take both because I didn't take deep pockets because I'm not very clever. Although we are guaranteed... Well, we want to use the strength card to buy the deal with the devil, basically. There's no point now using the strength card to... there's no point using the Perthrow rune to reroll the deal with the devil, because then we wouldn't be able to afford it. And we are guaranteed it. Although now... Well, we'll see what's inside it. It's going to stay open forever. It's the Bible, so we don't need it anyway. In fact, we can reroll it because we can leave it open. I think we might min-max this a small amount, actually. If you don't mind. So we'll come back. It's not far away. So I don't mind spending the time. We don't need that by any stretch of the imagination. We take the Perthrow rune. Because we kind of want to take the Emperor card to the Cathedral. Just to avoid having to do the Cathedral. Sister Maggie, which is not good enough at all. And we don't want the HP because Dark Bum's got us covered in that respect. But taking the HP there would compromise permanent Polaroid invincibility, which is one of the reasons we're actually winning. Chariot Strength, yeah. So we take the Emperor. Blow this Joker up, see what we win. A couple of bombs. NBD, but not great either. I would like to find Tinted Rock, but I think the easiest way of doing that is just leave this floor. And reboot to the next one. I won't take the HP and I won't take Sister Maggie. Although I could have taken the HP and then Sister Maggie. But Brother Bobby, I guess. But I don't want to. So you can't make me. That's an opportunity to use the Emperor card. For sure. Again, I don't think it's necessarily worth the effort. This is just a rumour to keep yourself alive, really. Which you failed to do even while saying it. But Dark Bum get you back. Dark Bum do not want you back. Dark Bum, why are you so mean? See, with a lower shot speed, it's actually perfectly possible to not take silly damage on that room. I got a biz. That's good. HP, please! Pin? Several pins. See a pin, pick it up. That viz just owned that pin. Extremely. I mean, I don't know what killed it. Maybe that explodey thing. Maybe they can explode each other. It's not very nice, but I guess it could happen. Stay back. Don't take damage. With all the things on the room, knowing what to... Fuck you. Dodge and what not to dodge are... it's becoming a little bit of a difficult ask. Partners. DB. Give me a fucking spirit heart. There you go. You... Dang Joker. I think the other thing is I'm using the Pokemons whenever it makes a noise. Which is causing me to take extra damage because I'm not shooting anything. I'm not even using the knockback of the things that I could be shooting. You know? That's mine. Okay. That's not mine. Why did that happen? Why was this even allowed to happen? This one's not mine. Which one's mine? Right. Whew. I might have to use the Emperor card on this floor. Just to get through these rooms. Earlier on, we were doing really well with our Pokemons helping out. But now, I'm not quite so sure that that's working out so well. Because they're dying a lot, which is kind of pesky. It's okay, except for when you get a Pokemon that is of this floor. And then it's like... Tower. It's getting really confusing as to which one's yours and which one's not yours. Like, gladly there's only one of these, but... I still shot it, even when it died, thinking that mine was it. Just avoiding these... Enemies in these rooms is turning into a nightmare because I don't know which ones to avoid. And as a result, I'm accidentally walking into the ones which I should be avoiding. You're causing it not to open. It's not helpful. Dark Bum, please. Dark Bum, please. How many HPs do I have to give you? You complete jabroni. At least walking those things into those is effective. We're going to lose a lot of Pokemons just because a lot of enemies in the game rely on contact damage to do their job. But maybe not so aggressive with respawning them, I guess. What? BS. Why is Dartbomb not giving me as many hearts as I need? That's a spider, bro. That's a spider. I don't need your spider, bro. And of course, sometimes they are charmed. That could be good. Oh, I've got belly button, of course. Easy to forget that when you've not seen a trinket in the entire fucking game. Dart B. HP DB. Dart Bum. You absolute bellin. What am I supposed to do in this situation? Well, we found the boss fight. So, just don't take damage. And you'll be fine. I took damage. We do have permanent Polaroid invincibility for every shot that we take, but the problem is, basically, we're not doing very much damage. We're still only on 5 damage, and our shot speed, rate of fire is fine, but not ideal. Yeah? Dartbomb has refused to pay out with actual HP in a long, long time. So, please help. Thank you. And this is Krampus. Yeah, of course it's fucking Krampus. The diagonal Krampus bullshit is diagonal Krampus bullshit, quite honest. Could we nerf Krampus? He didn't need the rotation attack. And he certainly doesn't need the diagonal attack, but having both is just... It's going to make me rant about it. It's basically what I'm saying here. There is red HP up here, so let's go and give it to Dartbomb and then try to not die to Blue Baby if we can avoid it. Oh, why is everything hard? We're doing great, except for the fact that we can't seem to get any HP out of Dartbomb. And it's all the confusion. It's so confusing trying to not take damage from your own things. Because you don't have to. You don't have to not take damage from your own familiars. That's what they're there for, but you... The room is just full of enemies, and the instinct is to dodge them all. And that's what they're for. We have enough bombs to find a super secret room. So I'm going to try. We can fly, so I don't need to dodge that, but... Oh. I actually didn't think it would be here. Oh, go on. That was so extremely worth it. Excuse me? 6. Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, every 1.5 is Dart Bomb stuff, right? So every 3 is 2. Which means 6 should be 4. So he only gave me 2. So Dart Bomb's currently at half effectiveness, which is not very fair. So what we're going to do is we're going to look into a room. Probably this one. See if we want to fight it. Not really. And then we'll Emperor card and just try and beat Isaac in this situation. It's our goal right now is to beat Isaac by continually respawning Pokemons until we get something that just beats the shit out of Isaac. Which is not going to be that fly. Happily, we don't have to do Blue Baby. Because that would be difficult. Just keep away from this because an explosion at this stage would be not fun. Just watch out for the myriad vectors of attack. Aww. I've actually got quite a lot of HP right now. I mean, it's not a lot of HP, but because we get permanent Polaroid invincibility to activate every time it happens, we got through the difficult stage anyway, but you know, we got enough HP that permanent Polaroid invincibility is relevant rather than just a joke because we got hit. I wish this Rolly thing would die because, yeah, I want to get a new Pokemon. Oh, shit. Don't stand in that corner, for goodness sake. Oh, help. Please. 5,000? He's telling me Isaac does 5,000 contact damage. Oh, that was rubbish. And permanent Polaroid invincibility really didn't last long enough to make that worth taking that damage either. I think we're going to be okay. Don't hold me to it. But if these baddies are just going to keep cannoning themselves into Isaac. Whoo! Hey, Darkbone, why don't you give me a spider for this and kill me by accident? Oh, okay, fine. Now you start paying out with HP, you ungrateful bastard. Charge key has appeared in the basement. That's just a key that is also a battery charge, which is really cool. Well, thank you for watching this episode. We did get through it, even though it took us a little bit of extra time. I enjoyed that challenge, and of course, keeping on theme made it a challenge rather than just taking something like Book of Belial and owning it anyway. So, hope you enjoyed it. If you did, remember putting a like on the video increases our rankings in search results and people will get to see it. Share it around with your friends as well, and subscribe to the channel if you want notifications of stuff about new videos. We have other people uploading too, so watch their videos and sass them because they're bad. Anyway, thank you for watching this episode, and I hope to see you in the next one.